Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. When we repair a board for treadmill and we find IGBT damaged, before replacing IGBTs, we must test the motor. If we replace new IGBT, first of all, try to find from some good source that you will find some perfect material, perfect brand. The second thing, we must make a test for the motor. This time, I am demonstrating that this motor, it have out of center shaft. If you see this wheel, it is not centered. I connected a piece of wire or any thing, just bring it closer to the wheel and we can see in some place it is touching, in some area it is not touching, it is out of center. If we check this corner of this wheel, we can see. So this is the problem. When we will install a repaired board with this one, or even we install some new board with this motor, it will damage the IGBT MOSFET immediately, or IGBT will get heat up. Why? Because the armature shaft is not centered. When it will run the belt, in some area it will make hard because this armature shaft is not centered properly. In some portion it will make hard, so that will cause to draw more current from the IGBT. So it will make pulses like this, as it is making here. This mechanical movement, it will directly reflect it to the electrical load. This time I am applying DC voltage to this motor. This time the voltage are 8.7 volts. Its uncentered rotation, it will cause to make more distortion in the IGBT output. That is here. We can see. And this vibration, this noise, it will continuously cause to heat up the IGBT. If it is like this, disassemble this motor and we can send it to some machinist on the lathe machine, and he can make the center for this armature shaft. Its pivot must be in the center. And if we see this side, it is also uncentered. We can see a visible twist on the pivot, so it is moving like this, it is rotating and it is vibrating like this. So this vibration might be, you can see in the camera here, it have also the same, and it have some noise. This noise, it is indicating that the rotor, the armature shaft, is touching to the stator. So it will cause to heat up the motor and it will cause to heat up the IGBT as well. You can see here is a huge vibration here. The same is here. And we can see its noise on the oscilloscope. The first thing, abnormal noise. The second thing, it have centered out. When any motor have centered out, it will cause to draw more current, especially when we are using IGBT, when we are using MOSFET. At that time it will cause to heat up. Now we have two options: send it to any machinist who will straight the shaft. We can send to some balancing machine. They can put some weight here, balancing weight. So that will also help in the balancing of this shaft. But the best thing to send it to any machinist, check the carbon brushes here. If the carbon brushes are about 70% worn out, so we need to replace it. Then we need to clean the commutator, inspect it. If it have too much carbon on the commutator, at that time we need to clean the commutator. We have to disassemble the motor and it must be cleaned. If there is inter-segment short, that must be removed. That short circuit becomes from this carbon. Its length is not within limit, it is shortened. So short length will cause to sparking with the commutator. Then take multimeter, set to continuity, connect with one lead, connect with the shaft, it must be open, connect with wheel, metallic part, so it must be open, connect with the second one, it is okay. Connect both wires to the input DC leads, connect to DC voltage and rotate the shaft. In one side it is giving DC voltage, so it is generating voltage. That means its circuit is working, its circuit is complete. Opposite side, so it is generating negative volt. It will depend on the speed. Then we need to test the bearing sometime. So this bearing is damaged, so we need to replace the bearing. So this motor needs bearing, carbon brushes, it needs balancing because its shaft is out of center. If it is out of center, and we connect the board, it will immediately, within seconds, it will damage the IGBT, the drive circuit. So these are the test ways we can test the drive motor. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.